Ensemble oversampling and undersampling combines ensemble tree models with sampling techniques to improve imbalanced classification. This tutorial uses the Python library imblearn to compare different ensemble oversampling and undersampling models and choose the best model for the imbalanced dataset. You will learn how to use balanced random forest classifier, how to use random undersampling boosting classifier, how to use easy ensemble classifier with Ada Boost, how to use balanced bagging classifier with near-miss undersampling, how to use balanced bagging classifier with SMOTE, how to pick the best model based on performance metrics. Hi everyone, my name is Amy, and I am from GranInfo. I publish step-by-step machine learning tutorials every week. If you are interested in data science, machine learning, deep learning, and natural language processing, please subscribe to my channel. Let's get started. The first step is to install and import libraries. We will use a Python library called Imbalanced Learn to handle imbalanced datasets, so let's install the library first. After successfully installed the package, you will see this message. Based on when you run the installation, your version of the package may be different from mine. Now let's import the Python libraries. We need to import make classification from sclearn to create the modeling dataset. Import pandas and numpy for data processing. Counter will help us count the number of records after oversampling and undersampling. Matplotlib and seaborn are for visualization. We also need the train test split, cross-validate, random forest classifier, and classification report for model training and performance evaluation. For the ensemble sampling, we need to import near-miss undersampling and SMOTE. The ensemble classifiers we will use in this tutorial are balanced random forest classifier, RUS boost classifier, easy ensemble classifier, and balanced bagging classifier. Using make classification from the sclearn library, in the second step, we create an imbalanced dataset with two classes. The minority class is 0.5% of the dataset. I made two features to predict which type each data point belongs to. The dataset gives us around 1% data points for the minority class. It is higher than the specified weights of 0.5%, but works for demonstrating the rare event modeling process. Let's visualize the data using a scatter plot. We can see that the majority of the dataset belongs to class 0, and a small portion of the dataset belongs to class 1. The third step is to do a train test split for the imbalanced data. In this step, we split the dataset into 80% training data and 20% validation data. Random state ensures that we have the same train test split every time. The seed number for random state does not have to be 42, and it can be any number. The train test split gives us 80,000 records for the training dataset and 20,000 for the validation dataset. Thus, we have 79,183 data points from the majority class and 817 from the minority class in the training dataset. In step 4, we will check the model performance using the imbalanced dataset directly. A model without oversampling or undersampling gives us a baseline to compare the model performance. A random forest model is used as an example here. We use cross-validation to evaluate the model performance and use minority class recall as the North Star metric. The five-fold cross-validation gives the recall value of 0.04 and the standard deviation of 0.018. This shows that the model only captured 4% of the minority class. In step 5, we will use the balanced random forest classifier from Python imblearn library. It automatically undersamples the dataset when bootstrapping from the training dataset. Random state makes the random sampling reproducible. Using cross-validate with CV equals 5 implements 5-fold cross-validation. In jobs equals minus 1 is for parallel processing. Scoring equals recall tells the cross-validation that the score we are interested in is recall. The balanced random forest classifier gives us the recall value of 0.557, which is a big improvement from the baseline model. In step 6, we use the random undersampling for the boosted trees. The RUS boost classifier gives us the recall value of 0.456, which is much better than the baseline model, but not as good as the balanced random forest classifier. The Python imbalanced learn library has a specific method called easy ensemble classifier for the ADS boost classifier. In step 7, we use 5-fold cross-validation to check the performance for the easy ensemble classifier. The easy ensemble classifier gives us the average recall values of 0.542, which is slightly lower than the balanced random forest calcifier. However, the standard deviation of 0.029 is smaller than the balanced random forest calcifier standard deviation. In step 8, we use balanced bagging classifier with near-miss undersampling as the sampler. Balanced bagging classifier gives us more flexibility to use different base models and samplers. The default base model is the decision tree model. Near-miss has three versions. We use version 3, which first keeps m nearest neighbors of the minority data, then select the majority data for which the average distance to the n nearest neighbors is the largest. The five-fold cross-validation gives us the average recall value of 0.504, which is much better than the baseline model but not as good as the balanced random forest classifier. In step 9, we change the sampler from near-miss undersampling to SMOTE oversampling. The balanced bagging classifier using SMOTE oversampling gives us the recall of 0.109, which is better than the baseline model but much worse than the models using the undersampling techniques. In step 10, we compare the five-fold cross-validation results and see that the ensemble models using undersampling generally perform better than oversampling. The balanced random forest classifier has the highest recall value among the ensemble methods we compared, so we will use it to train the final model. Notice that we are using the whole training dataset to train the model and use the testing dataset to make predictions. The model captures 51% of the minority class in the testing dataset. In comparison, the baseline random forest model on the imbalanced dataset has 3% recall for the minority class, so the ensemble method gave us a 48% increase in recall. In this tutorial, we compared different ensemble oversampling and undersampling models for imbalanced datasets. You learned how to use balanced random forest classifier, how to use random undersampling boosting classifier, how to use easy ensemble classifier with Ada Boost, how to use balanced bagging classifier with near-miss undersampling, how to use balanced bagging classifier with SMOTE, how to pick the best model based on performance metrics. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. The blog post has all the code and explanations in the YouTube video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.